Hey guys, now you can follow me on Facebook. Just go to facebook.com/UltraMaximusReviews.
Oh hey, it's King Hiss! You must kill Jaja Pinks. No wait,
You suck.
You are badass.
Yes, we are.
What the fuck?
Maximus back with 31 horror toys in 31 days, and today we're taking a look at another WWE figure. It's from their Monsters line. It's Jake the Snake Roberts. Now, I love a good wrestling figure, especially a classic wrestler from the 80s. That was my heyday of wrestling, and Jake the Snake was definitely very cool. He always brought this great big ball python out onto the stage, which is a lot of fun. I need to get a regular figure of him. This is the first one of him I've got in my collection. And he kind of represents the creature from the Black Lagoon in the new Monster series that came out this year. They've done zombies, they've done mutants, two waves of zombies actually, and this is their first Monsters run. And everybody in the wave has some kind of homage to the old Monsters of the 40s and 50s, which is very cool. You got Dracula and the Wolfman and the Mummy. This is the creature from the Black Lagoon. Definitely very, very fun. Let's go ahead and take a look at the packaging. So here we have Jake the Snake Roberts in package. And, I gotta say, it breaks my heart when I look at a figure like this and just wish, man, what would Glenn Webb thought of this? I loved him to death, and he loved a good wrestling figure, and he loved a good monster figure, and this is both. I mean, this entire wave just has him written all over it. So, buddy, I hope you're looking down from up above and enjoying all these great figures. Because the packaging on this, oh, look at this. It's just vintage monster look. I definitely dig it. Looks like an old poster from the late 40s, early 50s. And the logo down here, it's just very cool. There he is in box. He's got two snakes, which is a little bit different. And other than that, you really don't have much difference in him. He's got some fangs like the snakes, which is kind of cool. And then there's some like claw marks on the actual package, which is neat. So just kind of a close-up here, it says WWE Monsters, and there is the very cool artwork, and it says Jake the Snake in that old style art, and we got the claw marks all up in the package, looking very, very cool. Definitely digging that, the white line around like an old poster, just so iconic. Back of the packaging, here we have a little write-up of him as the creature, which is phenomenal. And then we've got all the other figures in the wave. So we've got like a Phantom of the Opera type character, a werewolf, a mummy, a Frankenstein, and a vampire. So definitely pretty cool. I don't know if I'm gonna pick any of the other ones up. I think if I was gonna pick another one up, it'd be the Undertaker, but I've already done a zombie Undertaker. I don't know. What do you guys think? Should I go ahead and pick one of those up and do a review? Leave a comment down below. So yeah, taking a closer look at the package, oh, I love that artwork. It just looks like an advertisement throwback from way back in the day. They did a great job with that. And there is the write-up. If you want to pause and read that, you are more than welcome to. And then here are the other wrestling figures in the wave. We've got the Undertaker as the vampire, Braun Strowman as the Frankenstein-type monster, Chris Jericho as the mummy, we got Roman Reigns as the wolf, and Asuka as basically the Phantom of the Opera. So yeah, definitely fun. I like the Monsters vibe this year. I think that is a nice addition to these kind of weird and creepy wrestler figures. Why they're doing that, I don't know, but I hope they keep going because it's really getting me to buy these wrestling figures. So that pretty much does it for the packaging. Let's go ahead and get Jake the Snake out of box and see what we think. So here we have Jake the Snake out of the packaging, and this is definitely a fun figure. There's only a couple really minor gripes I've got about this toy. It's a basic wrestling figure, so it doesn't have all the articulation of like one of the elites, but that's okay. I really like the fun value of these figures, and they're definitely different, and they're definitely unique. They have really good paint jobs for what they are, which impresses me from Mattel. So my biggest complaints are actually with the snakes themselves. The one is the fact that the snakes actually do not come off of the wrestling figure himself. They are separate, but they're kind of attached permanently onto him by the way it's molded around there. And the snakes themselves are not two different snakes. It's just one conglomerate piece that they've latched on there. I would have preferred if they would have made them two separate snakes that you could physically take off of him. I think that would have been a lot more fun. Now, the other complaint I have is with the jaw on this particular snake. If you look on the light green snake, the mouth does move up and down very easily. This one, however, does not. It just feels, I mean, the jaw and joint is there, but it just does not move as well as this one does right here, which is a bit disappointing. Other than that, I really can't complain about the figure. Everything else is pretty decent. Now, his head does have articulation, but it's kind of hampered because of these two snakes. Basically, it's reduced to his head moving up and down, which is a little disappointing, I guess. His arms have full range of motion, so they go up and around like that. There is a twist at the upper bicep. He's got a single jointed elbow right there. The hands do twist, and they are on a hinge joint as well. So that's pretty typical of these figures. And then he's got a waist swivel that is not hampered by the snakes, surprisingly. But it does look kind of funny. So that's kind of cool. His legs kick up that far. They kick pretty far back, hampered a little bit by the snake tail. Single jointed knee right there. There is a twist at the upper boot. And then there is a single hinge joint at the boot itself. And that's pretty much it as far as articulation goes for old Jake the Snake. So taking a closer look at the figure itself, you know, I like the detail on this figure. I like how he's got the two snakes. They're very horror movie classic looking snakes. They're two different colors, which I do like. One's kind of a lighter green, one's a darker green. And they look like the old rubber snakes of a 50s Monsters film, which I really do dig. He's got these kind of scale tattoos on his back. I don't know if they're supposed to be like actual scales like with the snake, or they really come across more as just green tattoos to me, which is cool. It's a nice little additive. I didn't even know that was on the figure until I got it out of the box. The head sculpt looks pretty decent. It looks like an evil vampire version of Jake, which is kind of funny with the fangs. But overall, I like the kind of cartoony, rubbery puppet look of the snakes. It really does bode to those old monster movies. So looking at the midsection of the figure, again, I like how the snakes intertwine around Jake here. We get the tattoos down halfway through his back. The sculpt on the body is pretty decent. It's standard what we get on the basic figures. I really do like the color of the pants. It's a nice light pastel blue, which, I don't know, there's something about it I really do dig. And I remember him wearing pants that color in the 80s. I just remember him being in blue for sure. But yeah, definitely cool. All the little sculpted detail on the snakes is nice. I just wish they were detachable from the figure. It'd be a lot more fun to have two snakes to be able to come off of him so you could have like three toys in one. I think that'd be a lot of fun, but alas, we do not get that. Now, a drawback on these snakes, you really probably would be hard-pressed to put a wrestling belt on this guy, but eh, you want it for the monster fun cheese, not the wrestling posing. And finally, taking a look at the legs of the figure, we get the kind of light blue leotards going down into the boots, And I love the paint job on these boots. This is where I think Mattel really excels on some of their figures, are these paints, especially like this, when we get the dry brushing and the black wash, or I guess a brown wash over the boot. It makes it look like real worn out leather, and maybe that he's been traipsing through the mud. I just really, really like this look. I think it looks awesome for boots. I like it when they did it on the zombie figures, and they brought it back at least for this particular monster figure, and they should just do that more and more. I mean, absolutely gorgeous paint. For comparison, here we have Jake the Snake Roberts as the Creature from the Monsters series of WWE figures with the zombie WWE figures, Stone Cold Steve Austin and Triple H. Now, I do gotta say, I think the zombies have a little bit better detail in their zombophoric gore. However, this guy is definitely cool and definitely different and has a totally different vibe, which I like. It does capture that monster feel of like the 50s and 40s, and I dig that. I really do. But I will say, as far as paint goes on the boots at least, we get that nice kind of leathery dirt covered boot that we get with the Triple H zombie, and I love how they brought that back. So is the WWE Monsters Jake the Snake Roberts as the Creature something you want in your wrestling collection? Well, if you don't like these kind of offshoot wrestling figures, this could be a very easy pass. Personally, I love them. I think they're a lot of fun. I think little boys like this kind of thing. You get the zombies, you've got monsters, they've done a mutant run. All of that is just really, really fun, and you know, it's different, which that's what is needed to sell toys. So I really do like it. A hardcore wrestling fan may not appreciate it, but I don't know, for some reason, for me it works, and I wish old Glenn was here to take a look at these monster figures, because I think he would have had a lot of fun with them, and you know, I would have just loved to see his review of these figures. So, Glenn, buddy, I hope you're looking down and looking at these figures and have a big old grin on your face. Thanks so much for all the memories on the wrestling figures. You got me back into wrestling, so I appreciate Glenn Webb very much for that. And yeah, there he is. It's Jake the Snake Roberts as the Creature for 31 Horror Toys in 31 Days.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, thumbs it up. If you hate this video, thumbs it down. To watch more Ultra Maximus, click on the links to the right. Don't forget to subscribe and share, like us on Facebook, and look for more videos in the future.